And I like this story because it's about a boy who learns to love his goldfish. And it's called Dogfish, written by Gillian Shields and illustrated by Dan Taylor. Dogfish. Everyone has a dog, except me. So I say to my mum, I need a dog. But my mum says, why do you need a dog when you have such a nice goldfish? She always says things like that. I explain that goldfish cannot catch sticks, or go for walks, or sit by your feet, and they never wag their tails. That is why I say, looking at her with my hypnotizing eyes, I need a dog. But my mum says, we'll see, which really means no. I look sad. My goldfish looks sad too. These are sad looks. So my mum says in her kind and caring voice, but honey, how could we have a dog when we live on the 44th floor? I think for a bit and say, 444 stairs would be very good exercise for a dog. Then she says in her soothing and explaining voice, but sweetheart, wouldn't the dog be bored all day when I'm at work and you're in school? So I think a bit more and say, it could read the paper. And my mum looks irritated but sorrowful like this. Then she says in her this really is the end of the matter voice, now darling, how could we possibly afford to feed great big hungry dog? But I say as quick as a fish, I don't want a big hungry dog. I want a very, very, very small dog that eats hardly anything at all, just scraps. Then we all look how people look when the situation is hopeless like this. After a bit, my mum says, well, if you can't have what you want, you could try to want what you have. She always says things like that. So then I look at my goldfish, and my goldfish looks at me with his hypnotizing eyes, and I think, maybe, just maybe. So I teach my goldfish to catch a teeny tiny stick. It takes practice. It's a tough job. Sometimes I think it is a waste of time. But we get there in the end and it feels good. This is how good it feels. I take my goldfish for walks. And he takes me for walks. We climb the 444 stairs together. When we are out, he reads the paper. He's never bored. He eats hardly anything at all, just scraps. In the evening, He sits by my feet and I tell him stuff. He's a great listener. He can even wag his tail to say I love you. He's not just a goldfish. He's a dogfish. So now when I see everyone with their ordinary old dogs, I say, why would you need a dog when I have the best goldfish in the world? I like saying that. And I look and my gold and my mum looks and my goldfish looks utterly, totally, blissfully happy, just like this. The end.